Welcome in the video series of mathematics class 10. Dear students, in the previous video of chapter circle, we learned how many circles can be drawn from a point, two points and three non-collinear points. We also learned the tangent theorem. Dear students, in this video, we are going to learn the statement of converse of tangent theorem and tangent segment theorem. So let's see.
Converse of tangent theorem. A line perpendicular to a radius at its point on the circle is a tangent to the circle.
Dear students, according to the statement of converse of tangent theorem, if any line is perpendicular to the radius of a circle at point of contact, then the line is tangent to the circle. Now here this line L is there, which is touching to the circle at point P, and OP is the radius. So here it is at the point A. So here you can see angle OPA is 90. Okay, or we can take here. So this angle is of 90. It means that this line is perpendicular to the radius at point of contact. Then this line L is the tangent to the circle. So dear students, in some question we may ask to prove that the line is a tangent to the circle. In that case, just we have to show that where is the point of contact, there is an angle of 90 degree or right angle triangle. So if we are able to show that there is a 90 degree angle, so by converse of tangent theorem we can say that the line is tangent to the circle at point of contact. So this is the converse of tangent theorem. Now let's see the tangent segment theorem. Dear students, before going to learn the tangent segment theorem, let's first try to understand what is meant by tangent segments. Okay? So here, if one asks you the question that how many tangents we can draw to a circle passing through a point. Now to answer this question, first of all, we should know that where is the position of given point. Okay? Now here you can see in this first figure a circle with the center O, and inside the circle, interior to the circle, there is a point A. Okay? So here we cannot draw any tangent in the circle that passes through the point A. Okay? As it is interior. So there won't be the tangent. Now in this figure, the circle is there with the center P and point B is there on the circle. Okay, so we are knowing that to a circle, from a point on the circle, we can draw one and only one tangent when the point is on the circle. Okay, and in this third figure, there is a circle with the center Q and point C is there, which is exterior to the circle. So dear students, from this point C, we can draw two tangents to the circle. Okay, you can see here from this point C, which is exterior to the circle, we have drawn the two tangents, that is tangent CA and tangent CB. So in this way, from the exterior point to the circle, we can draw two tangents. And each of these tangents, we can call them as a tangent segment. Okay? We are going to learn the theorem related to this tangent segment. So let's see.
Tangent segment theorem. Tangent segments drawn from an external point to a circle are congruent.
Dear students, here according to the statement, we have to prove that the tangent segments drawn from external point to a circle are congruent. Okay? So here we have the circle with the center O and point P is there, which is external to the circle. Okay? And from this point P, there are two tangent segments, that is tangent PQ and PR. So we have to prove that these tangent segments are congruent. Okay? So let's write down the given. Lines PQ and PR are tangent segments to the circle and points Q and R respectively. Okay? Then we have to prove that segment PQ congruent segment PR. Segment PQ congruent segment PR. Okay. Now, dear students, to prove these tangent segments are congruent, we have to do the construction. What is the construction? So here, draw the segment OQ, OR, and OP. That is the construction. Okay. Then, after drawing this, we will get the two triangles. What are these two triangles? Triangle OQP and triangle ORP. So, dear students, as we have to show that these segments are congruent, which are the sides of these two triangles. If we will show here these two triangles are congruent, so by saying that corresponding sides of congruent triangle, easily we can show that these segments are congruent. Now, how will show these two triangles as a congruent? To show the triangles as a congruent, we need three pairs of congruent elements. Okay, so let's see what are these elements. So here, in a triangle OQP and triangle ORP, these two triangles, here we will say that angle OQP is equal to angle ORP is equal to 90 degree by tangent theorem. Which are the angles? These angles, angle OQP and angle ORP. These angles are equal because each of 90 degree. Why these are each of 90 degree? By tangent theorem. We are knowing that tangent is perpendicular to the radius at point of congruent. Okay? So in this way we got these two angles as a congruent. One pair we got. Then as it is the 90 degree, so we can say that hypotenuse OP congruent of hypotenuse OP. Right? This is the common side for both these triangles. And this is the side opposite to 90 degrees, that's why we can call this side as a hypotenuse. Okay? So this hypotenuse OP is congruent of hypotenuse OP, that's common side. So we got the second pair. Now third pair, that is side OQ congruent to side OR. This side OQ congruent to side OR, as these are the radii of same circle. Okay? So in this way we got the three pairs of congruent elements, which help us to prove that these two triangles are congruent. So here we can say that triangle OQP congruent to triangle ORP by hypotenuse side test. Okay, so as these two triangles are congruent, that's why their corresponding side, that is PQ congruent segment PR by corresponding sides of congruent triangle. By CSCT, we now prove that here these segments are congruent. So in this way we have proved that the tangent segments drawn from external point of circle are congruent. Dear students, this theorem is known as tangent segment theorem. Okay, I hope this theorem is clear. So dear students, in this video we learn the statement of converse of tangent theorem and what is meant by tangent segment theorem. I hope these things are clear. Next video, we are going to solve some examples by using the tangent segment theorem and tangent theorem.